guys, and welcome back to my channel, Willy Nice Stuff. I am Brittany Willy, and today we are going to be talking about something very exciting. At least I hope that you guys find it exciting. I wanted to do a video about my story and my journey on eBay. What made me want to do this video is I just realized that I just hit $100,000 in sales on eBay since I started back in August of 2019. So I thought, what better way to do a milestone video than to tell you what I've learned in my first 2 years selling on eBay and what I might do different and any advice that I have for you guys starting on eBay. So if you are interested in some tips and tricks and what I would do different, then definitely keep on watching. I actually started my eBay journey in August of 2019. And I don't think I've talked about this on my channel yet, but how I started was my mom actually sent me a video of Ashley, Hustle at Home Mom. I'm sure you've watched her videos here on YouTube, but she sent me one of her videos, one of her older videos about selling $280,000 in 3 years or something like that. And so I watched the whole video and I was just blown away. I literally had no clue that people still bought things on eBay. I had no clue that eBay was a thing. I mean, literally, I had never even gone to eBay.com. So I was just mind blown, intrigued, and I thought, okay, I'm gonna check this girl out. So I literally watched almost all of Ashley's videos that day, that night, and the very next morning, I got up and went to a garage sale, and I found a pair of Tory Burch Miller sandals. I'm sure you've heard of those sandals. They sell like crazy on eBay, but anyways, I listed them, sold them within like 3 days. So I think I sold them that weekend and I was immediately hooked. I paid $20 and I think they sold for $60. So I was like, oh my gosh, and my wheels were just turning. So I literally just jumped in. I had no clue what I was doing and I just learned as I went. So starting off, I took stuff from my house, from my closet, my kids' closet, my husband's closet, and I started just listing stuff. I went to garage sales and start going to the Goodwills and the thrifts until maybe 1 week in or so. So that first week, I was just listing everything I could find in my house and things were selling. It was crazy. The first time I actually stepped foot into a Goodwill to find stuff to resell, I turned right around and walked out. I thought, oh my gosh, like I do not want to do this. It stinks in here, which it doesn't stink. Now the smell brings me joy of a Goodwill. If you know, you know. So I walked right out and then about 2 days later, I went back and I did find like 3 items that day, I think. I was hooked. So, you know, I would go to Goodwill with my kids, all 4 kids, every single day or every other day. I would find 30 to 40 items and I would list those throughout the week. So in the beginning, I was just listing in batches randomly, okay? So to give you an idea, my first full year on eBay was August 2019 to August 2020. I sold $37,917.32. My second year, which would have been August 2020 to August 2021, I sold $52,363.82. And then the last pretty much 2 months from August to now, which is October, I've sold $12,828.11. I did want to give you a breakdown and a timeline of what I was doing throughout that time and how many items I was listing and what was going on in my life, etc., because I feel like the background story gives you a good idea. Little disclaimer, you can hit 100,000 in sales on eBay far before I did. It is so possible, but I had a lot of things that set me back and I learned a lot of things as I went. And some of those things I'm going to share with you later in the video. So currently right now I'm at $103,000 in sales roughly for the last 2 years on eBay. It's pretty cool. Obviously keep in mind that is just sales. That's not the amount of money that I took home. And so, like I said, let's go back to the timeline. When I started, I was just batch listing 20 to 30 items a week, maybe just whatever I could find, as much as I could find. Then once I started seeing money really roll in, I thought, okay, I need to make a game plan of what I need to do. So from August of 2019 to January of 2020, I was growing pretty steadily. My store was in momentum, but not anything crazy. It was just growing, slowly, slowly, slowly. Well, in January of 2020, I actually found out that I was pregnant with my fourth child, Emma. And so when I found out I was pregnant with her, I got super sick, super miserable, and I literally stopped working. So I was still selling stuff, every few days, and I would always ship and always respond to questions, but I was not listing anything new from about January to March of 2020. So my store tanked, obviously. Store went down, obviously, because I was not consistently listing and playing in with that and feeding the eBay algorithm. If you are new to eBay, what helps your store is the eBay's algorithm. And what the algorithm likes is consistency, at least daily listings. And even if you can list on at the same time of day, that is what the eBay algorithm likes, and that's what boosts your store. So for me to stop listing for 3 months tanked my store. So in summer of 2020, I said, okay, I'm feeling better. I'm in my second to third trimester, and I really want to pump my store up before I have this baby. So I started working again. I created a schedule this time. I would go thrifting on Saturdays or Sundays when my husband was home to watch the kids. And I would go, sometimes I'd get a babysitter too. And I would literally go thrifting from, 8 o'clock in the morning until night, until the stores closed. I would hit all the Goodwills in my local area. At most, I would come home with 100, 120 items. So that was rough. It was a lot of work and a lot of digging. But that's what I had to do to get the inventory. So I would come home with these 100 items, and I would have that whole next week to get them listed. By this time, I had, created a space in my house for my items, and I was starting to, get more of like the business aspect of it, of this can really, really be something. So from summer of 2020 until, you guessed it, COVID, I was building my store up super, super well. I was actually due with my baby in September of 2020. So right before I had my baby, I was still going to the Goodwill, once a week, getting a ton of items. And when COVID hit, and then I was now a stay-at-home mom to four kids, my girls were actually home because of COVID. So I was homeschooling them. And then I had a brand new baby. So that was four kids at home. And I'm like, okay, wait, but I really want to run this business. So I was like, what do I do? At around this time, I started looking on Instagram, and on Google of where can I get inventory online? Where can I get inventory online? And at this time, that's when I found Jomar. If you aren't familiar with Jomar, definitely go check them out. I started ordering very heavily from Jomar from about November of 2020 until about 4 months ago. So, I was supplementing with odds and ends here and there. I would buy from B&G. I would buy a lot here. I'd buy a lot here, but mostly my items were coming from Jomar. I got some great items from them. Their business has changed some since COVID. When COVID happened, they were brand new. Like, their boxes were new. They didn't have a lot of followers. And I was like, hey, I'm gonna get some of these boxes. So, that is how I supplemented my business. And my store was still growing slowly, slowly, slowly. And I definitely was not consistent at all. Pretty much the first year and a half of my business, I was not consistent. I was just trying to balance home life, work life, make a little money when I can. So as I said, I started using Jomar to grow my store, and I continued to do that. Now, in this time at the beginning of 2021, we actually moved. We had to move into a new house, switch schools, switch towns, all of this good stuff, move all my inventory. So in March of 2021, I decided I'm gonna fully recommit to my business. When this happened, I made five changes to my business. First, I hired a virtual assistant. Second, I started running my business on Poshmark as well as eBay. Third, I started committing to listing 10 items a day, 7 days a week. Four, I started ordering liquidation pallets delivered straight to my door. And five, I just 100% committed. I did not stray away from what I was going to do on the nights when I'm so exhausted and I don't want to take pictures for the next day. I still do it. Even if it's 11:30 at night, I just fully committed, like no excuses. I'm going to do it this time. So, and that was in March, and I have been consistently doing that until now, which is October. And if you would like to see one of my videos about how I went from $500 to $5,000 a month on Poshmark in just 60 days, definitely check out that video. It is in the description box. It has some great information in it of exactly what I did to grow my Poshmark store. But in regards to eBay, this exploded my eBay store. So before, I was selling maybe $1,500 a month before I started committing. And now my store is all the way up to almost $6,000 a month in sales on eBay alone. So hitting this $100,000 milestone on eBay was a long time coming, but like I said, the more consistent you are, the quicker you'll get there. You can get there way faster than me. I have two biggest takeaways from my first 2 years on eBay. The first takeaway is consistency, 1000% consistency. If you're consistent, your eBay store will go into momentum. That could be 5 items a day, 1 item a day, 10 items a day, whatever you're doing, consistency is key. The second biggest takeaway I would say is to reinvest your money. I know you don't wanna hear that. Trust me, I don't wanna hear that either. We have become dependent on my eBay income, but the biggest thing that I've learned and how to grow the fastest is to reinvest 100% of your money at the beginning. 100% of it. If you are in growth phase, you need to be spending the money on more inventory. Otherwise, your store is going to stop. So when you make $200 in a week, take that $200 back to Goodwill to find more items to sell, you know, and keep doing that week after week after week, and your store will explode. It is hard to do, but if you can train your brain to not see it as your money, your business will explode. So what I want you to get from this video is that anyone can do eBay. Literally, you can be so busy with 4 kids and a husband and still do eBay. You don't have to have a lot of money to start eBay. You can literally start at the bins like I did. I would spend a full day on the weekend at the bins digging for treasures. When I was at the bins, I would only have to spend $150. When I would go to Goodwill all day, it would cost me $500 to $600. And that is gonna be different for everyone. You have to choose what's best for you and your business. Then that next week, the money that I made, I'd go back to the bins and buy more items. The trick is to crank that algorithm and get your store turning like a machine. Okay, you guys, that completes this video. I hope it wasn't too random and rambly, but I did just want to get on here and explain to you guys a little bit about my first 2 years on eBay. So I will catch you guys in the next one. Bye!